this is the review from the Maiden flight that happened yesterday. Unfortunately, I broke one of the rules of filming, and that is make sure all your equipment is fully charged and running properly. And I only got maybe 15 seconds of Maiden flight before my camera decided to switch itself off due to having lack of power. Okay, having said that, these are my comments and thoughts on the Eachine Spitfire flying capability. Beginner mode, she is gentle, docile, flies really stably. She's a great little flyer. I flew for probably about 5 to 10 minutes before I had a mishap, which I will get to in a moment. Intermediate mode, she's a little touchy. She's fast. As I said, a little touchy in the air. You have to watch out, especially going into the turns. In expert, she is a handful. The size makes it difficult to track at high speed. She did do a tip stall when I was turning, and I was able to recover just. Unfortunately, I left her in advanced mode when I came into land, and she ended up hitting a object very, very hard and damaging her nose. In fact, the propeller that she had on at the time got broken. It was that hard. Cracked the nose pretty badly. However, as you can see, she's glued back together. There is a faint mark here from the glue. And you can see some scuffing on the nose. A couple of the scuffs here are actually finger marks where I got a little glue on my hand, on my fingertips rather. She flies really nicely in beginner mode. As I said, I got about 5 to 10 minutes flight time with her. Definitely, I would recommend the Eachine as a second or a third aircraft. The big issue is the size. With somebody that has good eyesight, I don't see a problem. However, if you're suffering from macular degeneration or glaucoma, I would suggest something bigger. Or, as you will notice in some of my videos, I put a streamer on the tail, which helps me to be able to track much better, especially when she goes a little off to one side and is in my peripheral vision, and I'm not watching as closely as I should. On the whole, out of 5, I would give her a 4.5. As I said, she's a little a little bit of a handful in expert mode. I wouldn't recommend that unless you're really experienced, which I'm not. Great little flyer. 4.5 stars out of 5. I would definitely suggest that this is not a second aircraft, but a third aircraft. Getting back to the issue, next time I go flying with her, I will make sure my battery for my cell phone is fully charged so that we can get some good footage. Unfortunately, I didn't get on video the mishap at the end, nor did I get the flybys or the victory roll, which of course would go with the Battle of Britain music that I would dub over the top of it. Great little flyer. She's a sweetheart. Getting to the landing gear. Somebody mentioned the fact that the landing gear seems to be a little close and around the wrong way. Like the BF-109, the landing gear was actually closer to the fuselage and would swing out into the wing. This made it very tricky on the ground, and as I was told by my stepfather's father, who was a POW in the RAF camp Stalag Luftel 3, when he talked about the Spitfire, he would say that it was a little knock-kneed. Getting back to the Maiden flight, next time, hopefully I will get it all on video, and we will do a video of that, and I will give a full report with video so that everybody can sit back and enjoy. Lastly, please hit like and subscribe. It's nice to get new subscribers, and every one of you that do subscribe, I really appreciate you subscribing. Those of you that comment, I like your comments. Please remember to be civilized and polite. Thank you very much, and enjoy the video. Let's bring that out here. Okay. Okay, take two. Maiden flight of the Eachine Spitfire.